Hey, what's up everybody, and welcome to episode 4. Going to be playing Sniper this time. He's an agility hero. See, we've got these two passive abilities, take aim and headshot. We've got a shrapnel area effect, which will slow all enemies in that area. And then we've got the assassinate, which is just kill anybody in a huge amount of range. So let's go straight into it. Just like last time, I've got a build set up, so I don't need to worry about which items I'm going to buy. I don't need to worry about thinking which skills I'm going to upgrade. So I have tried Sniper in a few bot matches just to see which items might work well. Let's buy the items up straight away. We know what we want. We know what we're doing. So yeah, I've got this Novander to play build set up for Sniper. So going for phase boots because I tried playing Sniper a little bit and I use quite a fragile hero. I find I run forwards a little bit too much, thinking I can get the kill. Phase boots should give me a little bit of damage to help with the last hits, give me a little bit of damage to help with taking out the enemy heroes, but they'll let me get out of there quickly, which is the important thing. Maelstrom, again, attack speed and damage. Eventually want to be going up for Daedalus. Want to turn this guy into a right-click nightmare, basically. So let's see, enemy heroes. Actually have no idea which one of those I'm going to be going up against. There are a few heroes that the bots like to put in mid lane. Pretty sure it won't be Wraith King, pretty sure it won't be Drow. The battle begins. Necro seems to be more of a support hero. You wouldn't want generally put him in mid lane from what I can tell, but I have faced him against mid. Faced against him in mid before. That is one of the issues with the bot matches, is that it only really teaches you how to play mid and only teaches you how to play carry or semi-carry. When I come to play against real people, I'm going to... Oh, it is Drow I'm up against. I'm going to have no idea how to play support. See if I can port Drow back a little bit, move the enemies closer to me here. Oh, that was a shame. I want to go for deny. Did not manage either. That didn't get managed. The deny didn't manage the last hit. That was a shame. Again, I'm attacking the enemy hero to just actually try and pull the guys against me. At least I got the deny there. I'd rather not be fighting under his tower. I did want to pull everybody back a little bit. Nice thing about Sniper is that the range increases means that I can get out of the range of the towers. Eventually. Again, I shouldn't really be attacking unless I know I'm going to be doing a last hit on them or softening them up. Try and move the lane closer to my tower. Oh, try and move the lane whichever direction I wanted to go in. Let's just go get the rune. And I haven't been looking at what I wanted to be getting here. Can I just forward straight up? Oh, I can actually in just a second. Let's see. Let's Wraithman forward. I'm going to want boots. I'm going to want... No, not more phase boots. And then I'm going to be wanting to work towards the chrysalis, I think. Thrown a little bit because I forgot to... Ah, oh, I was aiming at the wrong person. I was thrown a little bit. I forgot to put on the items that I wanted. So now I've lost track of what I'm trying to do in the lane here. I've got a better range than Drow. I'm not paying attention here at all. Let's get boots there. And I... Oh, we don't actually have a flying courier. Can we get a flying courier yet? I know you've got to wait a little while. Yeah, we can. Might as well do that myself. Ooh. So I've just got the second range increase, which means I might be able to attack the tower without... Oh, it's invisibility. Could do a bit of damage, but... Oh. What I really want to do is increase my attack speed. Because there's a chance of me proccing a small amount of damage, or going to be a fairly large amount of damage. So increased attack speed is going to do a little bit better, I think, than increased damage at the moment. But I do want my phase boots. Because they will let me run away. No! Oh. Okay, an assassinate's going to make it a lot easier to do that in future. Let's get both of those. Nobody's got the courier, so I can be free to take it. Haven't been looking at the minimap so far, I've just been focusing on my lane, so... Starting to get to the point where I should be paying attention to where enemy heroes are. But right now I do want to be pushing the tower, let's see. Nice. Okay, let's just move back a little bit. Heal up. I was still going for the rune. Damn it. I didn't have my phase boots where I expected them, so I hit W and it was like, hey, where do you want to plant a tree? Which is not ideal. Okay, so Chrysalis next, which is going to be another blade of attack. Why my fairy fire I could have used to save myself then. Forgot about that. After Chrysalis, I'm not actually doing anything with these branches, am I? No, I'm not going to be working towards any of those things, so I could probably just sell my branches when I need space. So the build does need working on. I mean, it's not a terrible thing to buy branches that you're not planning on turning into anything. Magic wand would have been a little bit useful, but bots, I don't think, use abilities unless they think they're going to get a kill. And they're much better at judging whether or not they're going to get a kill than me. Fortification. Yes. Oh, I want to go back to the room. Oh, not quite enough. I'm just going to run away. I did consider looping around, trying to get behind. But I don't think that's really... Oh, cool, these guys still following. I'm just going to bring him back here. Being near the tower gives me a little bit of armor, so they're not doing as much damage to me. That's much easier to get last hits there. I knew I was going to miss one of them at least, but it's not too bad. I think at this point I just want to be fighting on this side. I don't want to be fighting under my tower anymore because tower's down. We've got a good chance of taking it. Christmas recipe. Yeah, I can take this before. One more. There we go. The enemy's middle tower has fallen. I think at this point I might as well just run back to base, heal up there, sell the iron branches, grab the blades of attack, grab the chrysalis recipe so that when I get 1200 I can just have the courier bring me my chrysalis, and after that I want to be working towards Mjolnir, or Maelstrom. I'm going to keep one of them just to the extra one in all attributes. Your middle tower is under attack. Although I could have... Actually, yeah, I probably should have sold the iron branch, got gloves of haste instead. But I wasn't looking really at how much money I had. Your middle tower is under attack. In fact, what I should have done was not buy the gloves of haste and just save it for the broadsword. Yeah, I'd say I'm playing quite badly. I'm not paying as much attention to things as I should be doing. I have definitely been making a fair few mistakes. I mean, it's not been terrible. I've only died once. Everybody's grouped up around here. Why are we all grouped up around here? Let's go take... Probably kill Nova boss. Your top tower is under attack. With everybody else there as well. Yeah. Guarantee the kill with that. What I can do is. Your bottom tower is under attack. I'm thinking maybe run into the shop, sell the iron branch there. Just so I've got space in my inventory. Not by the Maelstrom recipe. Maelstrom first, then Mjolnir. Not by the Maelstrom recipe. Let's save it for the broadsword. So let's try and pay attention to last hits. Which I almost did. Oh dear, okay, there's nothing I can do to defend that. I thought they were a little bit further away, should have been paying attention to where my ghosts were on the minimap. But looks like they're a little bit further. Okay, let's do this properly.
Your bottom tower is under attack.
Okay, are we... that you're not moving in? Push them back anyway, don't need to worry too much at the moment. I think I'm just going to stay on the tower. Or kill this guy.
Your bottom tower is under attack.
Nope, too late.
Are fortified. Dire structures are fortified.
Let's run away. There we go. Oh, I think I could actually run in there. I think you can buy that straight from the shop. But probably should have just run away from Juggernaut. That's too far away. It's not going to kill him. I don't mean too far away, I mean he's got too much health. Okay, I'm focusing on the catapult because I know that creeps, towers, everybody focuses on catapults last, so I know that I'm going to be able to get all the shots in on that one. Assassinate now costs a lot more mana. But, oh, we can take the tower now easily. Do I want the recipe? Let's see. Drow's down there. So I know I'm not too sick. I might be able to go after Drow. How is... No, I think up close. This was a mistake. Yeah, I used the fairy fire. Probably shouldn't have done that, it was a complete waste. But I can grab all of those now, so I've got a chrysalis, I'm on my way to... maybe... I don't have a lot of armour. So, late game I'm going to want either the butterfly or the assault cuirass to give me either evasion or armour. Your middle tower is under attack. I used the glyph earlier when I shouldn't have done, so we're just going to lose this tower now. Your middle tower has fallen. So the assault cuirass will be better against physical attacks, the butterfly better against magic, I think. Honestly, I'm not entirely sure what does what. For example, Assassinate, flavour-wise, feels like it should be a physical attack, but it actually does magical damage. And I'm just not familiar with the heroes enough to be able to say, okay, this one's physical, this one's magical. Yeah, let's get the Maelstrom just because, you know, I don't want to die and lose all that gold again. Only got 27 reliable gold. Reliable gold that you get from killing heroes, certainly. Possibly from taking towers, I'm not sure. Reliable gold does not go away when you die. Going ballistic. Okay, everybody's pushing. Nice. Still want to be the one getting all the last hits. Not a good team play, I think. Run away, not fast enough, I'm going to die. I'm glad I bought the Maelstrom recipe now. But, on the plus side, only I died from our team. I'd like to say I sacrificed myself for the good of everybody, but no. I shouldn't really have used the Assassinate. What I want to do was soften up Necrophos, so that we'd be able to take him down quickly in the fight. But Assassinate should really be used to guarantee a kill. But if I'd run away instead, we'd still have taken a good fight, and I'd probably be able to take out Dragon Knight now. Instead, things have turned quite badly. They all came back, and now we're losing nearly everybody. The Maelstrom's going to give me area effect, which is going to make farming a lot easier, so it'd be a lot better to get the next item I'm after, which... Aquila's not a bad idea, actually. Just go straight in and get the Ring of Protection, that'd give me a bit of extra armour. Should really have thought about that before leaving the base, because now I'm wasting a little bit of time coming back here. And there we go.
Your top tower is under attack. Radiant structures are fortified.
Okay, so popping the cliff was probably the right thing then, because these guys are not going to focus on the catapult. The catapult is only going to go for the tower. Use my phase boots to get here a little bit faster. Wasn't necessary, but we probably would have lost the tower then if I hadn't used the glyph. Where am I? Okay, so I've got a ring of Aquila on my way, which is going to give me a little bit extra agility. Going to give me better mana regeneration. Not that I'm really using Shrapnel and Assassinate too much. Okay, so they've just left the base. Let's put that down. No. There. There. And not the right place. So I'm kind of mumbling a bit here. Let's try and talk a little bit nicer. A little bit better. Talk a little bit nicer, that's a weird phrase. Okay, so Dragon Knight's here, he's got... That is not an item, that must be a spell of some sort, an ability from another hero. Okay, so we're pushing up mid, so I want to stay split pushing this lane. Okay, so they have to bring somebody back.
Your bottom tower is under attack.
No, that's not good at all. We're not too far away.
Your bottom tower is under attack.
Oh, that was a waste of shrapnel. I'm softening up the catapult, but it's not really that helpful, is it? Okay, everybody's here. Excellent. I was not paying attention at all to how the fight went in the middle. We didn't get the tower. Okay, got that there. Necrophos, let's just assassinate him. So we can't run away. And there we go. They're chasing down there. I'm going to do some damage to Drive. And I think I actually just had enough for Mithril, if I've been paying attention. I wasn't really watching. I was focused on the hero's health levels. I wasn't looking at how the people they were attacking were doing. So I didn't see when our guy died. Tunnel vision is a huge problem in this, I think, probably for all new players, for me especially, where I think, okay, yeah, I can kill this guy, and I'm only focused on their health, or I'm only looking at the minions in my way. Let's get the Sage's Mask. So we've got the Ring of Aquila. Might as well carry the Maelstrom. Okay, so we're all down here. Well, I'd like to get Boots of Travel eventually, so that I can not have to rely on 10 portal scrolls and I'll be able to move around the map, jumping to enemy minions. Sorry, friendly creeps. I think I'm dying to... Let's start working towards the Mjolnir. Because I'm nearly... That's not what I wanted. There we go, that's better. I'm alive and have been for a little while and not been moving about. That's a waste. And the Daedalus. Okay, so I want to push out this lane a little bit. I can't see where anybody is on the minimap. I think they're probably waiting further back in this lane. I know, so they're pushing out that lane. Got three charges on shrapnel. I should really be using that a little bit more often. It's only 50 mana. 2000, let's get Mithril Hammer. Shift H, so I'm not stealing the courier. Okay, I know the enemy up here. They know that I'm here because I've been a little bit too close to the enemy creeps, trying to get the last hits. So I think they're probably going to come down from this way. If they're trying to focus on me at all, which they will, because I'm threatening this tower now. So, Necrophos. I can't believe Necrophos is alone. I can now, because everybody's just appeared. Do I have anybody around here? No. No, we're all down. I'll just abandon this lane. We'll do what we can on bottom, because we haven't focused on bottom at all. I like to get the Hyperstone, so I'm just going to save up 2000. Just going to run away if I see any enemies. Okay, they're pushing top, I wasn't paying attention. So, Hyperstone I can only get from the secret shop. But there's one right there. Don't really need the Ring of Aquila too much. I will be selling it eventually if the game goes on too long. Get a Salt Caress and Butterfly that way, just to make myself double unkillable.
Your top tower is under attack. Radiant structures are fortified.
Given my range, MKB, Monkey King Bar would be a good pick. For, at least for taking towers, but... Oh, he comes back to life, doesn't he? Forgot about that. Oh, I'm bleeding through Necrophos. Let's just get out of there. Because remember when I said I was going to get out? And then I just died. Lost all the money I had for my Hyperstone. I'm not doing terribly. I feel confident we're going to win this game, just not as quickly as I would have liked, and not with. It's going to be a messy victory. I should really be looking at see. Okay, so Drow's got the Shadow Blade, so she can go invisible. Mordred Mask, so kill her quickly, don't let her attack you. And they're hanging out off screen, so I can't see anybody else now. So there's... I don't really want to buy the recipes when I've got inventory slots free to put the Demon Edge and the Hyperstone in. Gold for me. If I wanted... Yeah, actually, let's spend all the money right now. Get myself a... Talisman of Evasion, 1700. Which should hopefully mean I last a little bit longer. Although, it is just more fun to shoot super fast with a Hyperstone. So no. I think it's probably much better to build up the items to full rather than get a little bit from here and a little bit from there. Okay, so enemy could be defending mid tower. Could be pushing down bottom. Two waves of creeps with me now.
Your bottom tower is under attack.
I'd like to push them back to push the slain all the way back to their tower. Yeah, see they're all down at the bottom, so they can take a tier 2, we'll take a tier 3. Got enough of these things now. I'm going to send the courier to the secret shop to get it for me. I know I'm getting hit. It's not such a tanky hero like the Dragon Knight. The idea was they would focus on me. Juggernaut is there. Just get him and run away. Get him and run away. Let's get the Hyperstone. How much do I need? 900, so only another. Breaking is there. No. No, I'm just going to run away. Run and gun. Hopefully get enough from this. F21. My gold. Yep, that gave me enough to get the Molnir. Don't know why I was heading up this way. Where? Okay, enemy there. That's good. So I've ordered Town Portal Scroll so I can stay pushing out, and if they push too far down anywhere, I can jump, come back to base. Or if we get in this position again, where I'm very low on health, and up behind enemy territory, I can just nip into the trees and teleport down. So with the Mjolnir, I can put a static charge on a creep that I know is going to get hit, which means... Okay. So I saw Wraith Queen, no, Necrophos heading back, Juggernauts. Again, I'm going to be targeting the ranged barracks because it doesn't regenerate, and I want to do some permanent damage in case they all suddenly reappear. Although they might be pushing a little bit too far here. Dragonite's getting pummeled. Oh, healing. Juggernaut is there. And I got Juggernaut. Okay, so we've done pretty well in this lane. We've still got our tier 2 up. I'm doing some fairly serious damage now. What I want to do is get the Demon Edge. I don't know where the enemy are. I know that Juggernaut and Necropos are dead. Okay, so the others. Oh, Dragonite. I can get Dragonite. Great, I'm just. I get Wraith King as well. Should not have done that. I haven't been leveling up for a while either. Two levels there. I think one of them at least came from killing the enemy hero, so it's not too bad. But they're going to increase my health slightly. Which might have, wouldn't have saved me, but I should still have been paying attention to it. I don't know the keyboard shortcuts for leveling up, collecting stats and stuff, which is something I should look into, because every time I'm sort of panicking and. I can't level up while there's anything going on screen, because I need the mouse for that. So before we can see them, let's have a look. So that is physical damage, I think. Dragonite's gonna be magical damage there. There's, I guess that's physical damage. Get rid of the Daedalus. Let's get. I was at 875. Don't want to wait for that. Oh, I should probably have at least gone back for that. Let's see there. They're dying. They're mostly dead. I think if these guys distract the enemy. Oh, I can do some serious damage on drag. Healing up, probably not such a good idea to. But she was at least not expecting that. Let's force her back. And it cost me a lot of mana. But I can assassinate very often now. Well, thanks, Lion. Yeah, so, I mean, BKB might have been. I should really be paying attention to what it is that kills me. Is it abilities? Is it right clicks? I'm too focused on run away that I'm not actually looking at what attacks they are that are doing the massive damage to me. Your middle barracks are under attack. I can't buy back. Guys, come on. Okay, so we need to clear these two lanes, so mid I don't think is too much of a worry at the moment. So one of these guys are here. Bottom, I don't want us to lose anything too. Though he's going down there, so I'm going to go mid. Got no vision at all down here. Dragonite's dead, I don't know where any of the others are. With a static charge, do a fairly good job of pushing them out. Yes. I understand why they do this. One strength, one agility, one intelligence hero system during the tutorial section. But you're kind of encouraged to play mid carry every time. And I don't think that's right. I think it should be just a little bit more guided, the tutorial, so that you're told, okay, we're going to be... Didn't need to do that. So I'm losing track of what I'm saying. Okay, they're coming in behind. He's going to die, but he's going to come back. I got him anyway. Okay, it was... Oh... Assassinate wouldn't have worked because he had the BKB up. That's something I should have been paying attention to. Focus on Juggernaut. And... I think we should be able to just take it here. They've only got Dragonite alive. So that's game. I did really badly. I'm not happy with that victory at all. I mean, I'm happy we won. I had quite a lot of fun with that, but I played sloppily. Before the last couple of videos, I've done a few bot games just so I know exactly what I'm doing. This was the first game I played today, which is really how the tutorial section should go. It should be thrown in at the deep end, because I'm really looking at how this system would work for new players. And although I don't play a lot, I'm not really considered a new player in the same sense of people who are joining for the first time. Okay, thanks for watching, and I hope you come back for the next section, which will be an intelligence hero, Shadow Shaman, who I really know pretty much nothing about. I tried playing him once, just because I wanted to know what all these heroes were like for this series, which again isn't really the point of the series. I don't really remember him at all. So I've got a disable channeled ability. So I stand still, they stand still. Really, this guy doesn't want to be going mid, is what I'm seeing. This guy wants to be supporting. Mass Serpent Ward looks like it'd be good for taking towers or plopping down the middle of a team fight. And Aether Shock, good for clearing enemy waves. So, yeah, he looks like he could be quite a fun hero. Hope you come back and join me for that one.